Pauline's Field here.
Browning Field.
Browning Field,
yeah,
yes.
I just named it.
Let's name it Browning Field, all right?
Okay, let's do that.
Alleman Pioneers and the Moline Maroons.
You're absolutely
And we're
right.
sporting a new sponsor tonight.
That's neat, that's neat.
Want to tell us about it, Jim?
Well, sure. I'd like to welcome them as a major sponsor this year, Independent Insurance Services Incorporated. They're located at 1519 East Locust Street in Davenport, Iowa. If you want to call them, you can try 383-5555. And you know, it's kind of neat that we've come this far that we actually have a sponsor and to support a program like this. And they're involved with getting involved with kids. You mentioned too, it's nice to have somebody that we'd like to know more about them, huh?
We're gonna know more about them next week. Promise.
That sounds good. Well, how about the quick look at Alleman as far as coming into this ball game?
Well, Alleman had a nice tight ball game against Geneseo last week. And we were there. We enjoyed it. In fact, I thought they dominated the game for three quarters. Actually, they gave up one drive and a big break there that really hurt them.
Right.
Other than that, it was their ball game to win or lose. It was their decision.
Right. Well, they're 1-2 coming in, but actually you're 0-0 right now, aren't you, in the Western
League
6. That's
right. We're starting new.
And we're kicking this thing off. The Maroons now are 2-0. They had an open date there in the middle. Had a chance to see them against Belleville East, and they sported an outstanding ball control offense. They kept the ball about 30 minutes of that ball game, and just up and down the field, they dominated Belleville from the start to finish, and I thought they were just a real good team. They made a little adjustment in their lineup. Chris Beard last week against Pekin carried the ball 18 times for 175 yards and at the fullback spot. And that gives them Beard, Best, and Lofgren back there with Mike Finch at quarterback. That's a powerful group, and we're going to have a chance to watch those guys tonight. Kyle Piper, who played fullback, most of the two ball games they played, he's switching numbers. He's going back to 55, and that means he's going to start at center. So I think Moline's going to have a little added threat now at fullback, a little more speed maybe. And, of course, when you put Piper back in the middle of that line, that has to shore that line up also. So that's what we're looking at.
The interesting thing for Alleman now is going to be, can they move the ball on the ground the way they did against Geneseo? Because actually they had great luck in between the tackles and moving that ball.
They did. They really did.
And now with Matt Franks, if he is a better runner, a quarterback, this could give him another threat that would help him on that ground game.
Oh, I think so. And here again, records don't mean anything at this point in time. Tonight we're talking about Rock Island is going to play against Galesburg, and we've got to figure they're going to win that ball game. UT is playing Quincy and UT's homecoming at UT. Figure UT's going to win. This game tonight will make a big difference as to how this conference race goes. I think any of four teams can win it. I'm going to predict a three-way tie.
Three-way tie.
Three-way tie. Okay?
And you're not going to go out on a limb tonight, though, and say which three, are you?
No.
I didn't think you would. You should run for an office. You really should, you know.
Oh, yeah. No. Well, no. I really shouldn't.
Well, let's get out of here.
Yes.
The teams are going to the locker room. The band's about to play here and take a little break, and we'll be ready when the game starting lineup starts.
You better believe it.
The game's ready to go.
We'll be right back.
We're ready for these teams to hit the field.
Maroons, pride, honor, and spirit. Gotta like that.
That's neat, huh?
Gotta like that.
And the Pioneers are over there with a little hoop there to run
through. We talked about this with the hoop thing last week. Remember we talked about that just a little bit. You gotta be pretty darn tough.
Geneseo lost one going through the hoop.
Geneseo lost a pretty good guy last week trying to break through that hoop.
He almost got trampled by 30 other players.
I knew they were in a little bit of trouble with the cheerleaders stringing that hoop too tight. You gotta be a little cautious on that one. I will say this, remember last year when we did the ball game where Moline beat Alleman 27-20 in overtime. Remember that ball game
we had?
What a ball game last year over at Rocky Stadium. So the Alleman Pioneers are taking the field right now, and I just got a hunch they got something planned for the ball game, Brian.
Well, they're off to a good start. They made it through the hoop. They're all out there in the center of the field. They're ready to go. Now we'll see if the Maroons can make it, huh?
Got to do the starting lineup. Colin Cave is number 80, starting at nose guard for Moline.
Chris Edwards, number 80, or 90, for all of them, excuse me.
Number 79 is Chris Davies for Moline.
Seth Tron is for all of them.
Number 57 coming on the field is Nick Rude for Moline.
And for all of them, Ryan Woods.
Nick Massa, number 32 for Moline.
Number 72 for Alleman, Nate Polish.
Aaron Blythe, number 81.
Tackle for Alleman, number 62, John Arnold.
Daryl Michael, number 65 for the Maroons.
Number 60 for Alleman, Adam Stinson.
Number
for Alleman,
that's 55.
61, John Kearney.
I'm looking for Kyle Piper. He's number 55.
Brian Arnold for Alleman also
Mike
starting.
Mike Finch is number 12 as a defensive back. Chris Beard.
Mike Berry. Number 36 for Alleman, Mike Berry.
Todd Anderson's number 10. Chris Beard was number 7 coming out there from Olean.
Bill Healy, number 33 for the Pioneers.
Matt Siemens, number 34 for Moline.
Number 9, Matt Franks.
That was pretty quick, but we got the starters out there. The head coach from Moline is Dan McGuire.
And for Alleman is Dana Just.
And here come the Maroons. They're
and
ready.
We're going to draw attention to these boys. Get a better, introduction than that as we go. That happened pretty fast for me.
Real fast.
How about for you?
I kind of just lost my breath there in the middle there a couple times. Then Kyle Piper comes out as number 55 instead of 44, which we knew was going to happen. But I'll tell you, you start the Western Big Six campaign, you start in an outstanding facility like we have here in this conference. You look around this conference, everybody plays football in great facilities. Right now, the turf is in good shape here. Taking a look at the weather conditions, my guess now the temperature is probably about 65 degrees. There's absolutely no wind. One thing we talked about earlier, this field runs from
east to south.
East to west.
East to west.
You farm, son, don't you? Yeah. East to west, and this is why I think some of my UT teams didn't do very good here, because
we kept telling our kids,
run north, get turned north and south, and heck, we run out of bounds here all the time. So I think that was part of our problem. So, well, we're ready to play football.
I tell you, the atmosphere is perfect tonight.
No, it really
is. If you're at home, you know, if there's any way, you ought to get out there and see one of those high school games.
You really
should.
It's
hard to beat it, you know.
A lot of our fans I know are watching tonight have seen this ball game already and have enjoyed it once to begin with. But if you folks have any opportunity to go see the high school kids play, whether you're on the Illinois side or the Iowa side, it doesn't make a bit of difference. There's great football. The fans get fired up, and it's just a lot of fun. So get out and support your team. Alleman did win the toss, by the way, Brian, and deferred to the second half, and Moline chose to receive.
That'll be Pat Voss kicking off for the Pioneers, and we're about ready to get this game underway.
You better believe it. Deep is Chris Beard, number 7 for Moline.
The referee blows his whistle, and we're off.
We're ready to play football. Good luck, Brian. Oh, deep kick. That ball may go in the end zone.
Nice kick.
Nice catch by Chris Beard. Back out to the 20, finds an opening, and brings it out to about the 27 or 28-yard line.
Stripped up there by Ryan Wood, who just got enough to put him on the ground.
They set up a nice job that time, knocking some people down, setting that run
pretty
up.
Nice return, wasn't it?
That was out to about, what did we decide that ball's going to be on? About the 28-yard line. He must have caught that ball near the goal line, so a 28-yard return, first and 10 from Olean.
So Alleman sets up with that front line of Chris Edwards and Adam Stimson and John Kearney, John Arnold, and Ryan Wood. And here we go, the first play.
Mike Finch split into this side. Wishbone, second man through. On that carry is number 23, Aaron Best. That ball out around the 30, Bryant. If you can pick out a tackler on that play, there must have been about 6 of them.
I was hoping the PA announcer would have him.
Well, that's about a 2-yard gain, so it's going to be 2nd down and 8. Moline runs plays in with wide receivers. Dave Sable, 82. Phil Ledbetter, 84. Colin Cabe, number 80. And Aaron Blythe, 81. They'll be running plays in and out. Backfield, Mike Finch. Chris Beard's at fullback. Best and Lofgren at running backs. Wishbone. Pass. Wide open. Wide open, 82 is wide open. Great catch. Beautiful catch by Dave Sable. He's all the way down the 40-yard line.
Oh, man, what a gain.
That pass from Mike Finch to Dave Sable. Great play action that time. Sable broke wide open, the only receiver on that play, Brian.
He's finally stopped by Matt Franks and Mike Berry. Clear down here to the 40-yard line.
First and 10 from Olean. So we talked about run. Of course, They did pass the ball real well against Belleville. They had Belleville in a 6-2 defense, and they caused them all kinds of problems. See what kind of defense Alleman's going to play here tonight.
Well, they certainly executed that well.
A little 5-3 look. Yep, 50 defense. 5-2, regular 5-2. Zone coverage in the secondary. Pass again. Fly pattern. That's one we saw so much the other night with Alleman trying that against Geneseo.
Moline really opening it up here right at the beginning, aren't they?
You better believe it. Well, it's a little bit surprising insofar as that you sometimes will do that when you either see or assume that your defense is going to be something, you know, designed, maybe 8 or 9 man front against your running game. But that time Alleman was just in a straight 50, so Moline has put himself in a 2nd and 10. The ball's at the Alleman 40-yard line. Wide receiver coming to this side. 81 is Aaron Blythe. Wishbone. Tight end right. Power play off tackle.
Ooh.
Aaron Best.
Nice hit by Mike Berry, number 36 there. Got a part of that tackle.
I mentioned last time we had Moline. The backs do a good job of faking. They do a pretty good job of blocking for each other. That time, both lead blockers got stood up at the point of attack, and really Best had nowhere to run.
Adam Stimson also in on that tackle.
3rd and 8, Dave Sable back in the ball game with a play from Coach McGuire.
Well, this is a big play now for
huge
all the Pioneers
play.
Here in the
Well, because you're in a situation where maybe if you hold here with no gain, Moline will be forced to punt that ball
mm-hmm.
away. They break the bone this time, go to a pro formation, 2 wide receivers, tight end right. Option, speed option this way.
Quarterback option.
Finch with the ball, tackle right at about the...
It's going to be about a yard short,
looks
Coach.
Looks like it.
So it's early in the game on the 30-yard line, 31-yard line, you go for it, don't you?
You better believe it. 4th and a long 1, looks like. That time, I'm not sure whether the backfield action was correct or not. It was speed option coming this way, but one of the backs went one way, and the 2 backs came this way. Number 80, Colin Cave, is coming in the ball game. He's a senior. Going to go 2 tight ends right now. Tight wishbone backfield. On the first sound, straight dive.
I believe
straight
he's got
ahead.
It. It's going to be awful close. I think he's got it.
Chris Beard, number 7 on that carry.
And Moline front line with a nice surge there.
Doing
off
a
that
nice
ball.
Job. Up front, they're running with Chris Burns, number 77. Daryl Michael. The center is Kyle Piper. Terry Hansen and Chris Davies are on the left side of that line. They get off the ball real well. First down. Let's see if Moline now goes back and throws on first down or whether they're going to be satisfied to run that ball. But real tight line splits, Brian. 2 tight ends. Almost straight T.
Power.
Right up to about the 25-yard line. Aaron Best again on that carry.
Chris Edwards with a nice tackle there. I wanted to bring out the rest of the defense there for Alleman. We got linebackers Mike Berry, and the other linebackers split between Brian Arnold, 63, and Bill Healy. Both of them been in there already. And then DBs, we got Justin Hubbs, number 28, Matt Franks, 9, and Tom Hufford, 3, and Darren Levy. 25, and here come Moline again.
Well, you know, that looked like not much of a game, but that was almost a 5-yard game, Brian. Wider line splits this time. Wishbone, pass again, wide open in the flat. Beautiful pass, beautiful completion inside the 15-yard line, down to about the 13. Number 24 on that reception is Aaron Arms. Arms came in on that play, caught a nice pass in the flat. That time they had a flood pattern to this side, and they did cover the deep man that time, but the man coming in the flat was wide open. Kyle Piper leads him out of the huddle. Mike Finch at quarterback. First down. Off tackle.
Power left.
Another hard run. 24 on the carry that time is Aaron Arms. He's a senior, 5'9", 160.
Darren Lavery with that tackle, number 25.
Arms comes out of the ball game. Aaron Best comes back in. I mentioned in the pregame that 11 different ball carriers have carried the ball for Moline already in the first 2 games. So a lot of depth in their backfield, and they use them all. 2nd and about 6. 2nd and a long 6. The ball is just inside the Alleman 10-yard line. Oh, outside veer. Stuffed right at the point of attack. That time, Brian, I noticed that number 57, Nick Rude, has moved from center over to left tackle. So he didn't get replaced in that lineup. He just slid
moved.
Over to left tackle, and Kyle Piper dropped in at that center position.
How much time have they ate up so far?
Right now, we're at the 7:09 mark here in the first quarter. Yeah. Ball was at the mark at the 8-yard line. Big third down play now. Third and one, 5 yards to go. Little wider line split.
You know, typical, good drive.
Yes, they have. Double wing. Generally send somebody in motion out of this. Quarterback pass again. No place to go. If he can get through that tackle, he's got a chance. Not going to go. Mike Finch, tackle for a loss at about the 14-yard line.
Well, he avoided Stimson, but he didn't avoid Darren.
Yep.
Darren Lavery come in there 25 and finally got him.
Fourth and 10. Now, is Moline going to go with that field goal attempt? Or we're going to try to make something happen here at fourth down. The ball at about the 13 or 14.
I believe they're going to want to put something on the board if they've got a kicker.
They may need a timeout here to get this thing organized. Piper's going to stay in the ball game as they break the huddle. They got a different snapper in there, so we'll see what happens here. They're going to shift into field goal formation.
They have time to do all these things?
We've got to be about out of time. They need timeout. Moline calls timeout.
I thought...
6 minutes and 4 seconds to go, Brian.
I think we were all right until we went into all these shifts.
Well, you know, I think part of it was, again, they're bringing 43 in the ball game. That's Tim Perez, and he came in as the snapper. And that moves Piper over to probably a tackle spot because he slid over a little bit. And it kind of looked like they wanted to come up, maybe line up in a running formation and then maybe shift out of that.
Oh, yeah.
So, well, let's take a quick break, and we'll be right back with action here in just a minute.
We're on.
We're back.
All right.
Moline setting up now with their field goal attempt. Mike Finch is on kick. Our fans did at least. I did down at Illinois State. Did a nice job down there. Best, I think, if I recollect properly, is the holder. The snap is good. The kick is really good. And it is good.
Yes.
Moline on the scoreboard. 6:01 to go in the first quarter. Maroons lead 3-0. Nice drive, Brian.
Oh, yeah, they ate up a lot of time. They controlled the ball most of this first quarter, walked their way right down there. And it had really been a shame if you're a Moline fan if you didn't get something out of that. And they did an excellent job of getting their kick.
Well, I don't think I'd be talking out of class or whatever you might say, but I talked to some of the Moline coaches after the Belleville game, and I know one of the offensive line goals that they set for themselves is they want to have the ball 30 minutes of ball game. They want to have, now we've played six, and they've had it all that time so far. So if Moline can do that, they think they can win. Let's take a short break, maybe a message from our sponsor. We'll be back with the kickoff in just a minute.
Okay, so we're ready for the kickoff. You know, that was that's a victory for Allman, too, because they did stop that drive.
They sure did. Who you got back deep there, Brian?
We got Justin Hubbs and Bill Healy back there for the Pioneers.
Chris Beard kicks off. It's a bouncer.
Say Healy's going to get it. Go right up the middle.
Pads are popping out there right now.
Okay, so now we get to see what kind of direction Allman's going to take at this attack now. If we're going to open it up, or we're going to keep her on the ground.
Right. Well, Kurt Roberts, number 22, was underneath the bottom of that pile. Kyle Piper, number 55, was in the middle of that, too. So
no huddle. Pioneers right up to the ball. Matt Franks, quarterback.
Oh, man. Big hit inside that time.
Mike Berry, number 36, right up the middle. Going to get about one, maybe one and a half. Be second and nine.
I think Nick Rude, number 57, was in the middle of that. The inside fullback trap by Allman out of the I formation. Moline playing a 50 defense. 50 is kind of the traditional defense played here in the Western Big Six. If you got some good linebackers, that's exactly what you want to play.
Second man through. Healy with the ball. He's going to get about two more, maybe three. We're looking at third and about four and a half or five and a half.
Darrell Michael, number 65, was in on that play. Moline's running the ball real well. I don't know whether it's just the maroon uniforms against the white uniforms or what, but those maroon uniforms look a lot bigger than the kids out there in the white uniforms right now.
I think it's a stripe down the leg. Yeah.
I think it is. You're into
okay,
this.
Big third down play for the Pioneers. Right off the reel here now.
Yes, it is.
They need a first down pretty bad to get a little better field position, hang on to that ball for a while.
Two wide receivers to this side of the field. Speed option coming this way, Bryant. Nowhere to run. 57 on the play that time. Nick Rude working off his defensive tackle spot. Made a nice play.
Pretty well covered up. Pioneers are going to have to punt. Fourth down and about six.
Well, Brian, one series already, Moline was just a lot more crisp, I think, with their execution in their backfield. They're coming off the ball a lot better. Moline, you know, if that continues, Alleman could be in some big trouble. But here again, we're real early, and we know that Alleman is going to be in this thing before it's over. Oh, nice.
Ryan Wood with the punt.
Another nice kick.
Nice kick.
Back deep. Ball juggled just a little bit. Beard with the ball.
Oh,
number
good
seven.
Good coverage.
Not much place to run that time. Once he juggled that kick, that was going to be a real tough play.
Chris Edwards down there right away, along with number 79, Jeff Averville. Averville?
What number was that again?
79.
Right Averill, I think.
Averill?
Yes, I'm going to guess Averill.
All right, that sounds right.
If I did that one wrong, I apologize to the Averill family. Beard on the return, but he did a nice job. He juggled it, and then he covered the ball up and took what he could get. Ball is at the 27-yard line. Hard running that time. Out to about the 30-yard line.
Holloman plugged her up pretty good, but like you say, it's that surge of that line. They still get almost 3 yards.
You bet. Josh Lofgren that time on the carry. Again, rotating backs in and out. Lofgren carries the ball and comes right out of the ball game in his spot. End up number 24, jumps in there, Aaron Arms. Power the other way. Arms with the carry. Pops off tackle, turned around, going the other way.
Chris Edwards, nice stop out there. Really turned him around.
One thing we mentioned in the Belleville game, which has already happened here a couple times, Belleville was never, ever able to turn the Moline runners around. Every time they carried the ball, they were heading towards the goal line. That's twice already that Alleman's defense has been able to do that. Third down, 5 yards to go.
Another big play.
You betcha.
Big stop for Alleman here if they could stop him.
Wishbone, two tight ends, quick count.
Pass
again. Flood pattern, same flood pattern. Ball wide open. Number 82 out there on a nice catch near the boundary and out of bounds. Beautiful catch by Dave Sable. Mike Finch on a nice throw.
He was forced out by number 9, Matt Franks.
What, well, he caught him. Brian, but he caught him right in the middle of that seam out there. They did a nice job of covering number 24, Aaron Arms, out of the backfield, but there was just a little bit of a cushion in there, and Finch laid that ball into Sable beautifully, and that ball now right in front of us here where we're at. We're not quite where the camera's at, but it's at about the 47-yard line with 2 minutes, 51 seconds to go. Best on the carry, nowhere to go.
Chris Edwards come around from that defensive end and got him from behind, running up the middle that time. Excellent tackle.
Well, you know, maybe we ought to mention those two kids. We talked about, you and I were talking about with Wood and Edwards, how well they played last week. And how well they played for years, actually. And just two really tough kids, offensive ends, defensive ends. They do, you know, some tremendous things. On that last on the punt, for example, I think Wood punted the ball and Edwards made the tackle. Pass again. Same flood pattern. Looking for Arms out here on a nice catch. Close to the first down.
It's like about a yard shy from here.
Well, that was a nice play. And I'll tell you what, he was not wide open that time. Every time they've run that play, Allman's done a better job of covering it, but every time it's been a complete pass.
Yeah, they got some guys that can catch the ball. They run nice patterns.
Arms did a nice job. Got great speed. They also brought Sable out that time. They ran the two receivers a lot closer together than normal, but wide open. Third down and about one. A little different formation, a power formation coming this way. Look out. Nice run for the first down. Aaron Arms is being featured, Brian, right now in this drive. He's either going to catch a pass or he's going to run with the ball.
Tom Hufford, number 3 on a tackle. Maybe a scoring saving tackle there.
Yep. It's always a bad sign when your secondary people are all, you know, making most of your stops right now. So,
boy, when they're right out in front of us, the surge of that offensive line of Moline is yeah. 3 yards just instantly there. Yeah.
We'll take a look again at the formation. Last time it was obviously power because now it's straight wishbone. Our camera angle should be perfect. They could go either way. Now we'll shift double wing. And motion. Best in motion. Pass again. Looking to go. Oh, Bass was in the flat, but pretty well covered that time. Healy was going to make a big play, I think, on that one, Brian.
That's the first one that Mike has actually missed his man.
Mm-hmm.
All the rest of his passes have been right there.
Well, he was looking to go real deep that time. Number 30 popped Josh Lofgren, was the first receiver going deep, but Allman covered him real well that time. And a good quarterback isn't on a drive like this is not going to take a chance. Sable coming back in the ball game again. He's a senior, 5'11", 170-pounder, number 82. Lines up at tight end on this side.
Yeah, that makes second down a big down here now
you
for
bet.
The Pioneers.
Motion coming this way. Fullback. Oh, ball to the ground.
Holloman's got that ball.
Fullback had a big old hole there. That looks like that's the play they wanted to run, but the ball got laying in the middle somewhere, and Holloman recovers.
There's the first mistake of the ball game.
Yep. I'll tell you, if the fullback had that ball, he was going to run to the goal line.
Yes, he was going to run away.
He was going to run to the goal line.
He just forgot one thing, and that was the ball, right?
That's all. Well, the defense, set the defense here for Moline. Up front, they've got Blythe, Davies, Cave, Rude, and Massa up front.
Mike Berry gets the call that time. Gets about 3 yards for the Pioneers. Be second and seven.
Darryl Michael, number 65, was in on that tackle. He's one of the linebackers, along with Kyle Piper. Defensive secondary has Todd Anderson, Chris Beard, Matt Siemens, and Mike Finch back there in that secondary. It's an experienced group. They got real experience last week going against Pekin, I'll tell you that.
The backfield for the Pioneers, we got Matt Franks, Bill Healy, Mike Berry, and Seth Taranis.
46 seconds in the first quarter.
Oh,
my.
Berry met right as he got the ball. Almost in on the handoff.
Nick Rude, if he'd have made a pocket, he might end up having that ball going the other way. Big play in there. And then the cleanup with Michael coming real well at the end of that play. Nick Rude, number 57, was there to begin with.
Up front for the Pioneers, we got Chris Edwards and Ryan Wood, Nate Polish, John Arnold, John Kearney, Adam Stimson, and Craig Cramsey.
Big third down play again here late in the first quarter. Oh, they're there. Nice attempt. Boy, the pressure was on that time. Michael got there. Who met at the quarterback? Michael and Davies.
He just never got a chance to set his feet to throw
ball
at all.
Those guys were right in his face. Fourth down situation, 3.7 seconds to go. 3.7, Brian.
Allman just not being able to hang on to the ball for much time at all.
Nope.
Early here.
Not early. Things change. Things have a way of changing.
That's right.
But we're set for a punt here. Back deep, number 23 is Aaron Best. Number 7 is Chris Beard for the Maroons. Another good punt. Best coming to catch this ball at about the 35 to the 40. Back inside his own 40 and tackled at the 39-yard line as we come to the end of the first quarter, Bryant.
Nice tackle again there by Jeff Averill.
I think you're right there. Well, that's the end of the first quarter, Brian. We'll take a short break here. You're listening to Jim Sanders.
And Brian Mama.
Right there. We got John Medina on the camera. We have no technical director tonight. Remember that our major sponsor tonight is the Independent Insurance Services Incorporated. They're on Locust Street in Davenport, Iowa. Let's take a break, and we'll be back for the start of the second quarter.
Keeping your community strong is a responsibility for all who live there, whether it's through teamwork or working together to build a better town. Your Pekin agent will be there for friendly, reliable service when you need help and can't wait. Meet someone in your neighborhood who knows his customers. Depend on your hometown professional, your independent Pekin insurance agent.
Pekin Insurance.
For a quick quote on auto, home, and life, call your Pekin agent at Independent Insurance.
down. Yes, hey. Sir. First down, Moline. Here we go.
O'Brien, you ready? Let's go get him.
Yes, I am.
Moline ball. First and 10 on their own 39-yard line. Come out with two tight ends. Bench a quarterback. Power. Oh!
Big hit. Brian Arnold blitzed the inside linebacker spot and hit the hole perfect.
Man, Josh Lofgren that time just about had that ball put away, and all of a sudden he was laying on the ground, about a 3-yard loss.
Josh is going to remember that on Saturday morning.
Well, that baby got into his ribs a little bit there. Oh. That's going to hurt.
Yes.
And there's a play. Maybe a play like that sets Alleman up. Who knows? It's just they've been playing the first quarter just kind of a step slower than Moline, but we'll see what happens after that one.
Moline can take you up a notch, that's for sure.
You betcha. Pro formation, two wide receivers to our side here. Pass, screen. Wide open. Oh, look out. Oh, near the first down marker, number 24 is Aaron Arms. He's apparently their go-to guy in the passing game, but that was a nice screen pass. They faked a pass to the far side here, to our side over here, to the two receiver side, and set that screen up very nice.
A great time for that call.
You bet.
You know, Alleman steps up there and takes it to another notch.
Yep,
they're high, they're ready, and they're all hungry and coming.
You betcha. You betcha. It's not right.
It's not fair, is it?
It's just not a fair play. You shouldn't be allowed to run one like that when we're fired up on defense.
I can't believe that.
No. Short of the first down, sets up a third and less than a yard. The ball, and we are located, Brian. Our camera is different. We are located. At one point in time, we were on the 50-yard line.
Yeah.
John Knobbs up here with us, and he's kind of moving us over just a little.
We've lost ground a little bit.
Now we're back to about the 49-yard line. But the only problem is John now is located directly behind the post and can't see.
Quarterback sneak.
Yeah, I think he's well across that line, across the 50-yard line. So
first and 10, Moline.
Moline has done a nice job against Belleville especially. They'd either come out and go on a real quick count like that and quarterback sneak or run a quick dive play, or they come out and go on a long count, and then Belleville ran into some snags with that too. So it's really hard to get set up against these guys.
And Moline really looks sharp.
Well, I was impressed when they spent the very first game of the year, and I mentioned to our fans as we watched that ball game how really dominant they were. And I think Belleville's got a pretty good football team. I mean, they made Belleville look bad, but I think Belleville's pretty good. Fullback's up in it. No, quarterback ended up with that ball. My, I thought for sure that the fullback, Chris Beard, had that ball. He was loose. That's one of those cases where the good play action hurt him a little bit.
Three men on him that time. I got Brian Arnold out of that as one of them. I didn't get the other two, but they stuck with the quarterback, and they made the right decision that time, didn't they?
Well, Finch ended up getting tackled by three guys. That left nobody on the fullback, but for Alleman's sake, the fullback didn't have the ball.
Alleman looking on defense, just looking sharper all the time.
They're better. They're much better. This last series, they're much more aggressive. Much more aggressive. They're also coming off that ball real well right now. Pass again on the fly. Picked off.
Number three, Tom Hufford. Boy, he ran that ball down. He spotted it and just flat ran under it.
Well, a little miscommunication there. The quarterback threw the fly pattern, or the go, just the straight go, and the receiver about 20 yards down the field kind of pulled up like as if he was going to settle in maybe on a curl route or something, and the only guy open then ended up being Alleman's guy. And Hufford made a really nice play. Tom Hufford. He's a senior, too, 6'1", 150 pounder.
So, that's two turnovers now for the Maroons, and Pioneers take over.
Fullback got up in that just a little bit that time. Boy, both quarterbacks are getting jumped as soon as they hand that ball off.
Yeah,
I think Healy had the ball that time.
He got hit again there, didn't he?
Yes, he did.
So it'll be second and 9. I believe that was Healy. He got about a yard.
Yep. Well, they got Healy playing fullback right now, Brian, out of the I formation. They're talking about getting the ball a little bit more, and he's playing fullback right now. Justin Hubbs is at the tailback spot.
Quarterback keeper, Matt Franks has got it. He's going to get about 3 yards on that. So we're looking at about third and 5, maybe, or 6.
Well, I tell you what, that time, Moline definitely took the fullback out of that play, but he didn't have the ball that time. This is a nice play here. That was a good play. And Frank showed a little bit of speed that time. I think that's going to help them in the long run. course, he's a sophomore also. Aaron Ruthie's a sophomore quarterback, and Justin Hubbs is a sophomore quarterback. And, of course, Ben Lair, number five in the sophomore game. They got three what I would consider outstanding sophomore quarterbacks in this program right now. Look out. Oh, my. Not Todd Anderson that time. Knew exactly what was coming. He kept working around the receiver to try to get in the middle of that and couldn't quite catch that ball. But
I believe he was in the huddle that time.
Oh, my gosh. Well, the timing wasn't very good, Brian. The receiver had stopped and planted. I almost thought it was going to be maybe a stop-and-go kind of a pattern because he broke and stopped so soon, but he just
stop
stood there.
Stop-and-go would have worked there.
It would have worked there real good. Punt situation again for Alleman. They're doing this a lot.
Brian Wood.
Almost blocked that kick.
Had to hurry that one.
Best coming this way. Out across the 40 to about the 43-yard line, maybe the 44.
Brian Arnold with that tackle. Nice open field tackle there.
Well, he was coming this way, and Moline was, if he could have broken maybe a tackle or two there, he had a shot of going all the way. So the field position game right now is being won by Moline. They keep getting the ball at the 50, the 45. Alleman takes over, even on the interception. They took over at their own 20-yard line, 22-yard line. So you can't play a whole ball game like this and not hurt yourself eventually. But turnovers have killed Moline so far.
Yeah, Allman's bent, but they haven't broke.
That's
too,
true. Eh? Aaron Best, wide receiver. Moline broke the bone that time. Fullback trap up inside. Good hard run inside by Chris Beard.
Beard didn't want to go down, Coach.
No, he is a good, strong runner. But again, last week against Pekin, he carried that ball 18 times for 175 yards. So he's a workhorse. He can step up there and do that. Of course, he kicks off. He holds for the extra point. He plays the defensive secondary, so he's going to get a workout along the way tonight. Rose McGuire sends into play with number 82. That's Dave Sable. Second down and about seven. Double wing motion. Best in motion. Option quarterback keep. Up in it. Franks gets across midfield, across the 45, and down to about the 44-yard line. And that's going to be another first down for the Maroons. Brian, that play there is, as the quarterback faked the foot, it could have been either way. It could have been a call play where he's just going to follow the fullback up in there, or it could have been a read kind of a play where all of a sudden the fullback goes through and the quarterback realizes there is a hole there, and I'm just going to follow him up in there. So it could have been a called play, or it could have been just a good reaction that time by Mike Finch.
Quick count.
Oh, a little counter that time, a little hand back action. Ball goes to Josh Lofgren, number 30.
Tackles by Adam Stimson.
Got that ball down right at the 40, just inside the 40-yard line. Pick up about four, maybe long three. So let's call it, we're going to call it second and six.
How much time we got before half, Coach?
Right now we've got 6 minutes and 58 seconds and counting, Brian.
Well, you know, as much as Moline's had the ball this first half, if they don't push anything in yet this first half, why, you'd have to say Allman's hung in there.
Oh, no question about that. Well, you've turned, you know, in big games like this, people turn that ball over. Moline lines up offside and come out of that huddle and line up offside. So this is going to make this now second 11. But you're right, absolutely right. Moline, if you look at this first half and numbers of first downs, yards gained, starting field position, passing yards, running yards, it's all Moline. And you look at that scoreboard, it's 3-0. So Alleman's got to feel fortunate right now to be in this thing, and they're one big play away from putting themselves, ahead in a ball game like this. So the Pioneer fans are kind of quiet on the far side, but they're certainly not out of this yet. Three wide receivers left, fullback inside, spread them out, run up the middle.
Adam Stimson, the first man there again for the Pioneers.
Chris Beard on the carry that time, got that ball again back now to, oh golly, about the 42-yard line, make a third down situation, third and about eight.
As far as the power stuff, Alleman stiffened up quite a bit here.
They have. The run defense has been very good.
It's been the special plays, the screen passes, the quarterback draws and stuff like this. Just kept moving the ball here.
Three wide receivers to the far side. Pinch at quarterback. Quarterback keeps this one. Not going to work
this time.
Boy, Moline's
Mike
trying
Berry
to punch
right
that ball
there
out of
waiting
there.
On him to come around that corner.
Pinch on the carry, but Alleman's going to buy it. Right now,
Chris Edwards also helped on that a lot.
Right now, Alleman's not buying that three wide receiver stuff. I mean, you can send three guys out there, but they're just not going to believe that they're going to throw the ball right now. They're only sending, last time, they only sent two defenders out there to cover the three. Now, Moline's people upstairs are in the booth right next to us are picking that up. And watch for maybe a seam route or something a little later on out of that three wide look. Punting. Nice kick by number 42.
That's going to the end zone,
Kettler,
I believe.
Lands 2 yards deep in the end zone. So Kettler's punt, a nice punt.
So it's first and 10, Alleman on the 20-yard line with how much time?
5 minutes, 10 seconds to go.
I can't see the clock.
No, you
so
can't see the clock right
you.
Now, and I'm doing the best I can for
Let's
you.
Let's take a short break. Alleman ready to go right away here.
It didn't take him long to get in out of that huddle, did it? That evidently was not a TV timeout.
No, no TV timeouts here.
No. Look. Oh, he goes. He could go.
He got some room.
Healy might run.
He's turned
Beard
the corner.
Got an angle on him.
The 45-yard line where he's forced out of bounds.
Boy, Chris Beard had the angle, perfect angle, and headed him out of bounds. That time, if you'll notice, Alleman went out of that I formation, went to split backs, and they're going to run power with Healy, which now means with split backs, he can run dives and power from that formation. And he started one way and all of a sudden said, oops, I think I'll go back over here.
Well, I think that was a great example. If you look at the way Moline chases to the ball, Alleman needs to do something to get them chasing one way where they can get somebody open with a little room there.
Alleman going with two tight ends and split backs right now. Outside Veer.
Ooh, Mike. Berry there, nice gain.
That ball was laying out.
I didn't think he was going to reach him, did you?
I'm not sure how Matt Franks got that ball in that pocket, but he did somehow. 5 yard gain, Brian.
It looks pretty smooth after he got it.
Well, there's definitely a hole there. There's no question about that read. Now Alleman back to the eye.
And Berry was going through.
Kind of a 5-3 look by Moline now with kind of a middle linebacker running. Beard's going to run the flow. Beard has quarterback. Oh, my, what a play out there on the perimeter. Number 10 on the big play is Todd Anderson. If you take a look at the Moline defense that time, they're in a 5-2 defense, but they also went to kind of a stinger look or a rover kind of a look. Modern terminology, probably a spy look, with Beard just kind of chasing the quarterback down. And as soon as that ball was snapped, he had the quarterback, and he ran him down, and the pitch turned into a negative play. So we'll look again and see if they're in that again. We'll find Beard, number 7. He's going to play in there. He's going to drop right back in the middle again and kind of watch him. It's going to be man coverage on the outside here.
Look for Alleman to throw the ball.
Beard, it's all man coverage here. It's all man coverage, but nowhere to throw it.
Gets a sack. That'll make it fourth down.
Nick Massa on that sack, along with a couple friends, and Moline is held again. But Moline's getting that, like I say, that rover or spy look now, and they went three deep and played man coverage and had everybody covered.
Well, Matt, you got to give it to Matt. He ate the ball. There was nobody open, and he just sacked it in, and that's what he had to do there.
Well, right now, Alleman's losing the ball game 3-0, but they're winning the turnover game 2-0, so Best on the carry, coming off. Oh, nice run. Out near the 39-yard line.
So we exchange again, and Moline takes over again, this time on the 39-yard line.
Well, it's good field position, Brian, but inch by inch and little bit by little bit, the ball's moving towards Moline's goal line, and what's making it happen right now is the turnovers and Alleman's defense because you know, they started last time, I think they took possession right about midfield. Then it was the 45. Now we're back to the 39. So Alleman's got to feel pretty good about that. Moline's got a player come off the field. It was hurt. He's off the field now, number 32, I think, down here on the sideline. That's Nick Massa, and he's one of their standout players. Nick's a defensive end or outside linebacker, whatever your terminology would be. He's a good football player. They can't lose him. There's your trips. Take a look now. Alleman does have three guys in that vicinity. We'll see if we can try to throw one in the seam here. Off tackle. Nice run. Look out. A nice run for a first down. Chris Beard running away from the three receiver side, Brian.
John Arnold, number 62, finally on that tackle.
He's a linebacker. Is he a linebacker? Is he a, what is he, boys, D-tackle,
defensive
isn't he?
Lineman.
Yeah. Well, he must have got a pretty good angle at that one. Well, that's a big play. 2 minutes, 39 seconds. Now time becomes a little bit of a factor. We remember our fans, as we talked right at the opening of the ball game, Alleman did defer to the second half, so Alleman will get the ball to start the second half, so it's a key drive for Moline. Penalty flags have motion, I believe. Right open receiver. That ball got dropped.
Did he catch that
there.
Ball?
Incomplete. Nope,
incomplete.
It's on the ground. 24. Made
oh,
a nice
we
effort.
Got a hold, I believe, back here. We got
Aaron
a flag.
Arms, I'm going to call this one illegal procedure.
There's flags on the field.
Yes, there are. This is going to be a 5, I think. Motion penalty against Moline. They'll decline that penalty more than likely. Decline makes 2nd and 10, just on about the 49-yard line. The Alleman 49, 2nd and 10, 2 minutes, 20 seconds
oh,
to
we're
go
down
here.
With 2 minutes.
You bet.
The Pioneers just need to hang on here. I'd go in to half 3-0, considering
well,
the way everything's went.
I agree with you. I think
and be satisfied.
I would too.
Give Moline, them a chance to make some adjustments and see what they can do.
Moline used a timeout. Remember back on that field goal attempt, they had a little problem with getting the right people in the right places. So Moline has 2 timeouts left here in the first half. Pass again. Pressure coming. That's incomplete. Intended receiver was Dave Sable down there. But sets up a 3rd down now, 3rd and 10.
I'm a little surprised at how much throwing that we're seeing.
Well, I am too a little bit. Although I'll tell you what, Allman's run defense year after year after year has always been good. I mean, it's just very few teams are going to come in and play Allman and run the ball up and down the field for 370-some yards. Yeah, but even in the first ball game, and I apologize for not checking the stats real close for the Pekin game last week, but in that 372 yards, which is they had at least that much against Belleville, there were a lot of passing yards in there. They were big plays, you know, 50-yard touchdown passes types of things.
Well, they run their pass with a lot of confidence.
Yes, they do. Coming again. Oh, look out.
Oh, Chris Edwards has got the quarterback.
Nobody picked him up, Brian.
Looked like Richard Dent coming around that corner, didn't he?
Coming around the corner right on the quarterback.
Right quick.
And he didn't miss. 4th down, loss of about 6.
You know, the one thing that's really impressed me with the Moline is their swarming defense, how fast their overall defensive team speed looks to me.
Alleman or Moline?
Moline.
Yes. Team speed is good.
They close in a hurry.
Yeah, they do. They do. Both teams do, really. But this is your first look at Moline. They're impressive, aren't they?
Yes, they are.
Now, punt formation. Good snap. Good. 42 on the kick. It's Adam Kettler. Okay, and the catch.
Justin Hubbs with a fair catch. The 1st and 10 Alleman with 1:32 left in this first half.
I thought you said you couldn't see the clock.
It's hard to see.
Was it a guess?
It's
nice.
It's hard
guess.
To see. You have to be able to read lips to see it.
Okay. Wow.
So here come the Pioneers.
We'll take a look. I'm trying to check the sideline, check the field, and see if 32 is back in the ball game again.
I believe if I was Alleman right here, I'd just run that ball and get this clock out of the way.
I think so, too. Inside, not very smooth backfield action, and Moline closes on that in a real big hurry. Adam Kettler, number 42, is in there and makes a big play. Sure, everybody's in and out of that huddle now. I think that number 32 is back in the ball game.
Yeah, the one thing, it doesn't seem like the handoffs, the timing in the backfield is all as smooth as it was last week. Now, that could be because of the disruption of that defensive line, but still, I don't know.
It could be. It could easily be that. 2nd and 10, Bryant. Straight ahead, Barry, on that carry. Yeah.
He got a little air
nice
there
job.
And ran a little
now,
bit.
45 seconds to go. Now, if you're Moline, do you use a timeout here? If they don't, you're only going to have about 20 seconds left when Alleman has to punt the ball. But, again, maybe Coach McGuire and his group says, that we're ahead 3-0. Let's go make some adjustments in our offense, and we will come back and win this game in the second half. Let's not give them another play. 25 seconds to go. So after this play, unless Moline or Alleman chooses to be a timeout, this could be the last play of the half.
I would think they'd use their last timeout here.
There's your pass play. The ball, he's hit. That pass is incomplete. And the clock has stopped, Bryant.
So is my heart.
12.2 seconds. The air went out of that part of the stadium on the Alleman sideline over there when the quarterback dropped back that time.
Mercy. I was feeling pretty good about that 3-0 at halftime.
Well,
visions of lots of things happening there.
Well, right now, time equipment problem here, I think. But I'll tell you right now, that both teams, their pass rush is better than their pass blocking for their opponents right now. Both teams doing a great job of putting pressure on the quarterback. And Alleman's going to have to kick again. Be interesting to see the halftime stats and how many actual yards Alleman has had in this first half.
Well, that makes this kick pretty big. They're coming.
He got it off. Line drive kick.
He's just getting that kick off.
Oh, that ball got
by. Did he touch that
ball? He might have. He went back and picked it up. He fell on it. Very smart play. 2.6 seconds to go when Moline takes over.
Ooh, what a first half.
Man.
3-0.
I'll tell you.
Moline on a field goal.
Yep. Well,
2 seconds
now,
to go. What do you call here?
2.6. I'm going to drop on a knee if I'm the quarter. I'm going to drop on the knee and go in and talk about this thing. Moline leads. No sense taking any chances on any crazy plays. Coach McGuire, of course, he's the guy that's the head coach in this league and been winning a lot more ball games lately than I have, so he's allowed to run a fullback up the middle for about 85 yards for a touchdown, so who knows? Ball is on a 25, so we'll see what happens here. Three wide receivers to this side. One play in this quarter, fullback up the middle. Here he comes.
Hey, you called it.
Look out. Big yardage. Beard out near midfield, across midfield on the last play of the half. Chris Beard on about a 25-yard run to end the half. And, Brian, we're at halftime here at Browning Field. You know, this is a QCA TV sports production. It's channel 38.
Hey, this doesn't get any better than
that. No, I know.
3-0?
I know.
Huh?
Wonderful. Wonderful.
Let's take a break and let Ness sit down a while. What do you think?
How about that? We'll be back in
just
a minute.
DARE is a simple acronym for Drug Abuse Resistance Education. It's a drug prevention program that not only focuses on the negative aspects of drugs, but also on the positive side of life.
DARE helps teach young people how to resist peer pressure to take drugs and to resist the pressure to join gangs.
Community schools with their local police department offer the 17-week DARE program.
DARE to make a difference.
To Browning Field. We got ourselves a real ball game here tonight. 3-0, Moline leading here at halftime, and it's been Moline dominating pretty much as far as having the ball and gaining the yards and getting the first downs and all the things that's supposed to count. But they're only leading in this game 3-0, Jim.
Well, I'll tell you what, you're exactly right there. You talk about statistics, halftime stats, Moline's got a real good balance with their attack. They've got, I think, 84 yards rushing and 80 yards passing. And Alleman's got about 35 yards total offense. Moline's got 8 first downs, and the only first down that Alleman got was on the kind of the broken play where Healy kind of turned it back away from everything and got a first down there in the second quarter. So, like you say, I think very important factor here. One, Alleman gets the ball to start here the third quarter. Let's find out whether Alleman's made any adjustments, can start moving that ball. They're not going to win this ball game, even though they're hanging in there right now, unless they can take the football and move it up and down the field.
Well, the battle in the trenches has to even out a little bit somewhere in the second half if Alleman's going to have a chance to win this game.
You're right there.
The first half, Moline definitely was playing on the green side of the ball.
That's right.
Well, anyway. Huh?
Does the ball have a green side?
Oh, yeah.
Moline was definitely playing on the green side of the ball.
You didn't like that?
Well, I don't know. I don't understand that. That's my only problem. I think it's cool.
I thought Alleman's colors were green.
Oh, I see.
I thought
the green,
green
side of the ball.
They were playing on their side more than on the maroon side. There's a maroon side of the ball.
The maroon side of the ball, too. Well, now, see, I get it now. I was having a little confused. You got to understand, you're dealing with the football
I had to reel you in there.
Yeah, football guy, you reeled me in. Yep. Okay.
God,
I think we're ready to play. I'll
you
tell
had
you what.
Too much pop.
Well, I had those M&Ms, too, but don't tell Joanne. I'm not supposed to have any M&Ms.
No, we won't tell.
Don't tell Joanne with peanuts.
Hey, any of you people out there,
don't tell
Joanne on the street. Don't tell her.
I had no. We're ready to play football here. Moline's ready to kick off, and number 7, Chris Beard, will kick off. Who you got back there deep?
Well, I would imagine we got Justin Hubbs and Bill Healy.
You're exactly right.
Yes, we do.
What's this blocking up front? Again, Moline's done this consistently. Squib kicks. Nice hop there.
Hubs with the ball.
Look out. Moline's running to that football. Number 30 got there first is Josh Lofgren. He had some help from his friends. Number 42, Adam Kettler, is there. And Kyle Piper, number 55, shows up on all these special teams, too.
I'll tell you, this, I could feel something there as Moline come down that field right there. They come down there like they meant business.
Moline, I think, obviously, the momentum is going their way. Even, I mean, you look at the board, it's 3-0. I understand all that. But when you're dominating a football game, you know it. And right now, in this first half, Moline dominated that first half. Big hit coming out of there. Kyle Piper, number 55, big hit from his linebacker spot.
Mike Berry with that carry gets about, 1.5 yards there, be second and about 9.
If you want a good matchup, our camera angle should be pretty good. Take a look at number 80, Colin Cave. He's playing nose guard. He also plays tight end. He's lined up right over the center. Watch this battle at the football. Center got a little early that time. He's going to separate.
Third down. Allman retains the possession. Not sure if the quarterback never got that ball or.
Well, I was isolating like I asked the fans to do on the center nose guard combination. The center on the snap really submarined the Cave, and maybe when you're coming out that low, you're not getting that ball up to the quarterback.
I think he heard you going to look at this battle.
Offset now. Moline's going to go with an offset defense pass. Can they get some pressure quick? A little quick screen here. Referee's going to call it incomplete. Says that ball bounced, so.
I believe it did.
3 and out. Total net yards of 3 yards for Alderman that first series. Same as the first half, Brian.
Well, Moline's come close on this punt several times in the first half. And I'll tell you, Alderman better brick up the wall a little bit because they're going to get one of these.
And look at the field position they're liable to get. The deep guy's back here now. We've got Best, number 23, and number 7 is Beard, and they're standing about their own 35-yard line, but I don't think the ball is going to carries to the 40. Best with the kick.
There's a clip
right there. Flags coming in from everywhere.
On the field everywhere. Yes.
Yes, there were.
Like a shower.
Tell you what, that'll be a little film study, and we'll figure out.
Edwards got a piece of that tackle.
Yeah. And that's a big field position change, Brian. That ball's out here at the. Well, what are we looking at here? 42 or 43-yard line. You mark off 15 yards.
Again, Moline's enjoying good field position right off the reel.
But not now. Not after 15 yards.
That's going to change things.
That's right. So sometimes we talk about this a lot. You know, sometimes it's not necessarily what you do good. It could be something somebody else does bad. But Alderman needs a break. Maybe a 15-yard penalty like this is the break they've needed, at least to change the field position.
You could see that penalty coming before it happened. It might happen, and it did happen.
Well, anytime you get a runner starting one way and all of a sudden he decides to come back the other way, sometimes that sets up perfect blocking angles, and sometimes it sets up clip angles, and that one set up a clip angle all the way. One back set with Beard, the fullback, or the one back here. He's going
to
get the ball off tackle. Got it by the shirt. That has good play by Alderman that time, but a nice gainer.
Now they had good luck on that play in the first half. Moline lined up there strong to the left and then runs to the weak side. And looks like they got about 7 yards on that.
And you understand, of course, Alderman's sending three guys out here with the three wide outs. That creates kind of a gap in your secondary there. And if you can pop the guy loose, you've got to tight end to that side. So you got enough blockers over there to one-on-one block. And if he hits that crease, he could go. Again, three wide receivers to this side for Moline. Quarterback is Mike Finch. The lone back is Chris Beard, number 7. He gets it on a trap inside. Beard could run. He may go. Look out. One more cut, and he can turn it on. Beard. Nice block for Beard. Piper way downfield through a nice block, and Beard is tackled down about the 26 or 7-yard line.
Finally run down by Tom Hufford.
That's about a 47-yard run on a fullback trap inside.
I think that was Matt Franks that ran him down, Coach.
He did a nice job, I'll tell you. And I'll tell you what, Piper had to be involved as a center in a double-team block. They're going to run the fullback trap. He's got to be involved in the double-team. He ended up being 35 to 40 yards down the field, throwing a key block that kept two tacklers off of Beard's back and allowed him to get another 5 yards.
That's offensive blocking at its best. You bet.
Coming out of that huddle, here come the Maroons. Three wide receivers to this side of the field. They've got a tight end to the far side. Quarterback draw. That's not going to work. Holloman's in the middle of that one.
Brian Arnold comes knifing through there and wraps him up good.
Well, that's the quarterback draw off that same play. Knife through, didn't he, Brian?
Yes, he did.
Yes, he did.
Wrapped him up.
That's neat. Well, I'll tell you, we know one thing. The Pioneers aren't going to quit down here.
These yards are going to
get really hard. Holloman is going to buckle down, and they're going to get real tough right here, right now. Second down, loss of a yard that time on the quarterback inside trap, Mike Finch. Shifting defense by Holloman. Speed option. Quarterback keeps it. No place to go. Makes a good cut. Gets to the outside. Fish the 20. 15. And he's got down around the 13-yard line. Maybe the 12. Mark at 13-yard line, Brian.
Darren Lavery with that tackle. I ain't kidding you. That hit play didn't look like it was going anywhere.
Well, we talked about Finch in the first ball game we did against Belleville. He did an outstanding job in that game of reading. That time, he had the patience enough. He saw that the pitch man wasn't going to be any good. He said, well, I'll take my lump so I have to, but I'm going to get up in here. And all of a sudden, that thing just popped wide.
He made a beautiful fake of the pitch right there and lost the man right there.
That's right.
Really set that up.
And, you know, most of these teams have set their defense. Somebody's supposed to tackle the quarterback, and that guy went with a fake. Three wide receivers. The far side. Ball's on the ground. Look at that offensive line come off. You take a look at how many maroon jerseys have moved. Piper moved 7 yards downfield.
Usually if there's a fumble on the snap, all the linemen are piled up around. You can't hardly see. The quarterback was laying there naked.
I know it.
Nobody around.
It was unbelievable. Kyle Piper had his man about 5 yards downfield on a play that where the quarterback dropped the snap. But it's a negative play from Moline. They don't need one of those right now. It's second down and almost 11. Three wide receivers to the far side. Tight end left. Beard off tackle. Beard pops clean to about the 5 yard line. Beard on an off tackle play.
Well, we're going to be looking at fourth down and about
third down, I think, Brian.
Third down and three?
Yeah. Or
third
if they don't get it this time, we will be looking at fourth down and something. You were just a play ahead. That's all. Go ahead. You heard of a day late and a dollar short?
Yeah, I was a play late.
Ahead. You're a play ahead.
Late.
You never know.
Third down and about three.
Third and three. Ball is located at the 6 yard line. Holloman needs to make a big play here. Boy, they spread them out. Spread out and run up the middle.
Exactly.
Same play. Stop inside the five, about the 3 yard line. That's going to be fairly close. Fairly close.
Hard to tell from this angle.
It is.
They're saying fourth down.
They're not measuring it, so it's fourth and a yard. Fourth and a yard at the 4 yard line.
Well, it's going to be real hard to stop the Maroons on this drive, telling you.
Well, they came out motivated. Their defense just jumped to the occasion. It actually started with the kickoff.
Yep.
They jumped to the occasion.
You can feel it.
They've dominated this quarter. Quick count. Fullback inside near the goal line this time. Beard is at about the 1 yard line.
We're looking at balls about the one. At the 1 yard line.
Or it's first and one at the 1 yard line. Either or.
As far as you can go.
You want to go 10, you can go. First and goal, the ball located at the 1 yard line. That last play, Mike Finch on a nice handoff to Kyle Piper, and that line just come flying off the ball.
It's going to be hard to deny that line down here.
Kyle Piper leads him out at center.
Holloman needs to gamble here a little.
There's a touchdown.
Moline.
Beard on the carry. Up the middle, a 1 yard touchdown run. Brian, what an impressive drive that was.
Well, they pretty well stuck between the tackles that time and just power football
the
field.
And they pretty much stayed with the same formation. They ran the three wide outs with one back set and ran back to the tight end side. You ordinarily you'd say back to the weak side, but when you're running to the tight end, that really is the strength of your formation, even though you got three guys over there.
Exactly.
Extra point attempt here. Beard to hold. Good snap. Finch to kick. Kick is up. Kick is perfect. And with 6 minutes and 30 seconds to go here in the third quarter, the Moline Maroons now lead 10-0 over the Holloman Pioneers.
But just from the time they took the field, there was a feeling that you could tell about that team that they were going to move the ball.
Yep. You're right. And you know, and all of it did, every bit of it, the special teams, okay? Even the clip was an aggressive play in the middle of all that the mix there. But the kickoff team did a good job. Three and out, only allowed Alleman 3 yards in the first series, and a punt. Took the ball, took possession, drove the ball all the way down the field and scored, and used up a good portion again of this quarter. 6 minutes, 30 seconds to go, and Moline now has a 10-point lead.
Exactly. Holloman's really going to have to reach back now and see what they've changed at halftime here and see if they can get something going. Who's kicking off?
Well, Moline.
Yeah, but who?
Oh, you mean you want a name?
Yeah.
I'm going to take a guess here and say it's Chris Beard.
I got Justin Hubbs and Bill Healy back for
yes,
the Pioneers.
Well, if this follows to tradition, they're not going to let these guys run that ball back without having that ball down that grass. And again, we talked about it a little bit last week. You know, that grass is starting to get a little wet down there probably. So as this ball rolls down the field, it gets harder to cover. Let's watch the Maroons as they come down. Line drive kick. Healy fields it on the bounce. Look at this. Oh, my gosh. Unbelievable.
By two trains.
Oh, my gracious. Aaron Arms, number 24, was in the middle of all that, and about four other guys. I had, I think 24 was in the mix there somewhere, too. Wow.
That just kind of punctuated the attitude of Maroons as they come out of the second
half.
I'll
tell you what, there were about four guys on a collision course with Healy that time, and what a play. Look out.
Ooh,
option
Franks
that time.
Is tackled in the backfield. For loss, looks like about 3 yard loss.
Nice play on the perimeter that time. I'll get you a number in just a minute. Should be number 81. Yep, Aaron Blythe, number 81 on that tackle. Played it perfectly. His responsibility is quarterback. We talk a lot about option, Brian, and the good option teams, as you watch them, that quarterback ends up what we call going downhill. He ends up going from a fake and then towards the line of scrimmage. And that play, Alleman's quarterback was heading backwards. And if you get heading backwards, one guy can cover the quarterback in the pitch if he has to. So they got to get going downhill if they're going to run option against a team like Moline. There comes the fullback.
Barry gets a little running room.
That's more like it for those Alleman kids.
He's going to be close up there, about a yard. Well, maybe he's there. I can't tell for sure. I think he's going to be a little short, first down.
Yeah, third and about what, one or two?
About one.
Finch, I think, on the tackle that time. Mike Finch, number 12, the quarterback.
Good blocking that time for the Pioneers.
Very good. Quick trap looked like inside that time. Popped him clean. Holloman that time did the same thing. He ran two wide outs. The power eye this time, Brian, out for Holloman. Wide receiver, tight end this way. Power eye. Fullback
Barry
got through
again.
Clean again. That's more like it. That's more like the Alleman teams we're used to watching,
yep,
isn't it?
Exactly. I'll tell you, they got the work cut out for them because that momentum has really swung a long ways the other way.
That time we got our first look in this ball game, at least, of the power eye. Running Healy as a deep back, but giving the ball to Barry up inside and leading a guy in front of him. I got to figure out who the other.
Well, that's kind of what we expected coming
look
in.
Look who they're running at that dive or the blocking back in there, Coach. You got Chris Edwards playing in there. Option. He's still not going downhill, though. He's going backwards, and that's a 3 yard loss.
Oh, Moline strung that out excellent,
didn't
he?
Oh, my. Number 32 on the tackle that time, Nick Massa. I mean, when you come down as a quarterback, there's supposed to be some kind of a gap to run into.
Yeah, it's supposed to be a little hole for you to cut up.
And he looked at all those maroon jerseys. Then the closer he got to the sidelines, there's a whole bunch of them standing over here, too.
I know that gap's out there. It's just a long way to it here.
My gosh. And that play was clear behind the Moline bench, I think.
So we're looking at another loss, a second and 12.
Well, you can't get a first down then every time and then come back with a negative play on first down. So it looks like Alleman's going to go with two wideouts this time, back to the basic eye formation. The dump is wide open.
He was open if
yes, he
hits him.
Well, you see Kyle Piper drop back as a linebacker there and kind of got back in the mix that time. Kind of had to throw it over his head, and then he's going to throw it over everybody's head.
So we're looking at third and 12.
Yeah, that's a tough situation. Dana Just and his staff, his coaches up here in the box, that's a tough call right now. There are not many plays on their play sheet, Brian, that are working. They haven't got very many. We'll see what works on third and 12. Oh, pass, halfback pass. Oh, Beard's there, wide open, picked off. Good as a punt. Good as a punt. Beard intercepts.
That pass was meant for Steph Tranez. Made a nice play and tackle there on that.
Yeah, and here again, though, that's just a tough play to execute. You go with a halfback pass, and you really haven't hurt him with the sweep yet. I mean, if you don't hurt somebody with that sweep once in a while, Beard had no reason at all to ever come up on that play. So he just played center field, ball went in the air. He was the closest guy. He went right to it. Now Allman's really got to play defense, Brian, this time. First and 10, Piper leads him out of the huddle. Finch is a quarterback. Beard is the lone back. Three receivers to the far side of the field, tight end to the near side. Trap off tackle. Here comes Beard rambling up there near the 45-yard line. Tearing him up with that trap.
Certainly looks like we're to the point in the ball game where Moline's offensive line is beginning to take its toll.
And Allman calls timeout. And we got 3 minutes, 42 seconds to go here in the third quarter. And Allman's going to have to make an adjustment. So why don't we take a break? We need to make a little adjustment here.
All right.
Okay, we'll take a short break. We'll be right back. I'll tell you what, it was to be a little bird in that Allman huddle over there and see what kind of defensive challenges the coaching staff.
Yep. Very tough position right now.
Second and short, less than a yard. Wishbone, quarterback's going to keep this one. Look outside. Nice cut back. Excellent first down run by Mike Finch. That's that old student body play we talked about last week, except now the quarterback ends up with that ball.
Boy, he runs so patiently and just picks his way through there.
Well, he hid behind his blockers, which is the way to do that. We used to tell our kids, we used to always let our quarterback get involved in that sweep. Remember, we did that because we want him to pitch it, and because we knew the quarterback was never going to touch anybody. Going through, we told the running back, just follow the quarterback. He's going to get through clean. You just follow him right on in there. It worked like a charm sometimes. Boy, ball's in Allman territory again, first down. That Moline line is really coming off that football.
Yeah, knocking
Chris
off
Davies,
big chunks
Terry
now.
Hansen, Daryl Michael, Chris Burns. Because you got Kyle Piper at center. Piper, look where Piper's at and where his man's at back there. Guy's getting knocked off the ball 7 yards.
Chris Edwards again with a nice tackle come in there.
Two subs coming in the ball game for Moline. Nick Rude is coming in the ball game. And Chris Davies is going to get a rest. In and out of that huddle in a hurry. This is the Moline team I had a chance to see down at Illinois State playing on that AstroTurf. And, boy, they go on to win this ball game. It's setting up our game of the week next week. Guess which one that is, Brian?
Oh, my.
UT Moline at UT. What a ball game. Oh, he's gone. Look out. Chris Beard. That is a 45-yard touchdown run up the middle for Chris Beard. Excellent blocking up front. 16-0, Moline, and with 2:25 to go in the third quarter, the Moline Maroons have taken charge right now, Brian. They lead 17-0 over the Allman Pioneers.
Well, the holder did an excellent job there of getting that one down.
Yes, he did. Well, I'll tell you, the snap was good, but Beard juggled the snap just a little bit, and boy, he got it on the tee.
He recovered excellent.
You know, I've been impressed with Mike Finch both games I've seen him, how well he kicks the ball, how far he kicks the ball. Here again, matchups next week. UT's got Terrence Clark that's going to kick that ball and potentially 45, 50-yard field goals. He got Mike Finch that the one field goal he kicked, he could have hit that one from at least 20, 25 yards farther than he kicked it in there. So special teams next week may be exciting too. So, man.
Well, I can tell you one thing. After watching Moline play, UT's got their hands full to compete against them.
No
Moline
question.
Has an excellent front there, and their backs, their execution is excellent. Their quarterback's excellent. They just have a fine football team.
Well, and I think, you know, we talked in the pregame a little bit, and I don't know that I went out on a limb at all, because I think Rock Island has an outstanding football team. I think Moline has an outstanding football team. I think UT has an outstanding football team. I think we've got three great teams, and I think it's very conceivable that each of these three teams could, you know, they could beat each other and end up with a three-way tie before this is over. But I will say this, whoever comes out of this Western Big Six this year and represents this area, we could have very easily have three teams in the playoffs. All three will be very, very competitive come playoff time.
Oh, I'm sure of it, yes. Well, here we go. Got Healy and Hubs back.
33 is kicking off this time for Moline. That's David.
Ball gets by Healy. He runs it down.
Oh, there's all maroon shirts there. There's all maroon shirts there. Because there's 10 maroon shirts at the football.
Not a good sight when you look up and you're looking for a place to run,
is it? What a special teams play. 10 maroon jerseys there. where that play ended, and the play ended, Brian, at about the 14-yard line. Oh, my. The Maroons are dominating.
Yes, they are.
They are tough up front. They come off that football.
Well, Aaron Ruthie's in at quarterback now for the Pioneers this time. And they're going to throw the ball.
Well, they're going to have to do something, Brian, for first down.
They get a big first down right off the reel by hitting Pat Voss with a kind of a slant in there, quick slant. So the Pioneers pick up a first down right away here.
That's good. Now, Ruthie came in and completed the pass right off the bat. That's pretty darn good. Two wide receivers out here.
Hey, Barry. He's going to get about 4 yards on that carry. It'll be second and six.
Yeah. Moline's made a couple changes up inside, Brian. Scott Manicky is a 6'2", 220-pounder. Junior is playing nose guard right now. Number 42, Adam Kettler, is in as one of the defensive tackles. So a little bit of an adjustment there. Giving some guys a little bit of rest. Motion early that time.
I think we had movement there.
Number 56 is in at linebacker. Get a couple subs in here. That's Grant McCauley. He's in, giving Kyle Piper just a little bit of a rest. So Moline's defensive unit getting a little bit of rest for some of these kids that are going both ways. So, and they're doing well, and this group's doing real well. Well, when things go bad, sometimes they just kind of go from bad to worse. Right now for Alleman, they gain a couple yards. Well, they gain a 4, 5, 6 yards, and all of a sudden they end up losing about a penalty.
Well, different cadence, you know.
Very possible. Shouldn't happen, but it does happen, no matter what level you're at. Pro formation I for Alleman. Pass. Looking for the tight end.
Wide open. He lays it in there. Beautiful. To Wood. Ryan Wood, number 80, with a nice catch. First and 10, Alleman.
A couple first downs. Ruthie's come in here.
At about 35-yard line,
yeah.
Coach.
Yeah, Ruthie's come in and made a couple nice throws. Some good catches and two first downs.
That was a tough throw there. He had to get it over that linebacker and lay it right in there.
Had a guy in his face, and the good thing about it, he had a little arc release on that by the tight end that time, put himself right out in the seam, and he was open. But as you say, it's got to be a touch pass there. If you rifle that, linebacker knocks it down or picks it off. Let's see. Moline's kind of gone to that stinger look again now with that middle line, deep middle linebacker. He's going to rotate. That's
Barry.
Best now. Best right on it. Best comes from that spy position and just puts his hat right on that football.
But Alleman picks up about 4 yards again on that first down.
Grant McCauley, number 56, was in on that stop, too. The defense I'm talking about with Moline, our camera angle may be pretty good for that. Occasionally, Moline's coming from their four-deep secondary, which would be basically a zone coverage with a monster, and usually Matt Siemens is that position to more of a three deep look. We're down to the last second or two here of the quarter. We'll take a look at that as we start the fourth quarter. But I'll tell you, the crowd on this side is a lot more fired up, Brian, than the crowd on the other side.
Oh, yeah.
So why don't you take us to a break here? What do you think?
Yes. Well, Alleman's moving the ball now and got something to feel a little better about. So we'll see what happens at the beginning of the fourth quarter. Let's take a break.
Community strong is a responsibility for all who live there, whether it's through teamwork or working together to build a better town. Your Pekin agent will be there for friendly, reliable service when you need help and can't wait. Meet someone in your neighborhood who knows his customers. Depend on your hometown professional, your independent Pekin insurance agent.
Pekin Insurance.
For a quick quote on auto, home, and life, call your Pekin agent at Independent Insurance.
quarter. Pioneers ball, second and about six, the 45-yard line.
Moline, Brian, has put the starters back in the ballgame. One with the spy, Best on the run. Spy man is there. We talk about that. We're talking about, again, a 5-2 defense, five down linemen, two linebackers, and Best, number 23, is lined up about a yard and a half deeper than the linebackers, and all he's doing is following the football. There's nobody, if you take a look at the numbers game, there's really nobody that can get to him. What happens, though, and if Ruthie at quarterback throwing the ball better, it puts you definitely in man coverage behind that. So you've only got, you know, you got no help. There's no zone cover. You're not going to get any deep help or anything else. So,
but Moline's got to know they're going to face a pass here.
Right, and they're back to the regular cover here. Now Best is walking back up in there again, so it's man coverage on the outside. That's going to be a screen pass, and they're going to try to get it there. Nice coverage outside that time.
Incomplete.
Number 10 on a nice play outside there. That's,
so that brings up
Todd Anderson.
Fourth down for the Pioneers, and they're probably going to kick the ball. I don't know.
They're on their own 46-yard line, something like that. If you're going to run a fake, this would be as good a time as any to do that.
I don't think that's going to happen.
Remember, they got Healy as one of the up-backs, and Barry as one of the up-backs, so anything could happen here. Not going to happen, as you said. Short kick, Best ready, fair catch, drops the ball. This could be the break Alleman needs. Scramble for the ball. Alleman picks it up, and Alleman has
the ball. First and 10 inside the 10-yard line, at about the 8-yard line.
Man alive. There's the break Alleman's needed for the whole ball game.
Number 90, Chris Edwards,
I believe, on that recovery. My, oh, my.
My, big play.
That was wild, wasn't it?
Well, the plan was good. Best made a fair catch signal. Obviously going to get decent field position, taking no chances, but he just didn't catch the ball. Then it got loose. Then all of a sudden, there's nothing but white shirts chasing that darn thing down. And a big break, third big turnover for Moline. And look out. Ball is located. We're going to call it. It must be about the 12 or 13-yard line, Bryant. Man. Jumped him in a big hurry inside that time. Nose guard, number 80 on the play that time. That's Colin Cave.
Healy had that ball.
Yep.
Got about a yard. Be second and 9.
Yeah, this would be a huge, huge touchdown if Alleman could put this ball in the end zone. We'd have ourselves a football game again. Just about the time you try to think about counting Alleman out. Here they come.
I believe they're going to have to throw the ball here on second down.
Yeah, they're going with a one-back set again, though. Ball wide open. Look out.
It's got to be touchdown. They call that a touchdown, and Alleman gets it in there on a pass to Ryan Wood.
Ruthie has done a nice job, hasn't he?
Oh, yeah.
Ruthie's done a nice job. There's plenty of time, Brian. 10 minutes, 26 seconds to go here in the fourth quarter, and Alleman is starting to work themselves right back into this football game.
They're going to go for two? What do you think?
I think they're going to go for, well, they're going to go for two. That's what they're going to do, but still you need three scores. Now they're still going to, no matter what they get here, they need three scores to get there. Boy, they've got Moline running all over the place, and we'll see what this penalty is. Moline was not adjusted,
illegal,
but unfortunately,
procedure.
Now you might think about kicking the ball. You play for the win, obviously, and so if you get 7-7-3, you're able to tie the ball game up. So if you can get an 8 here somewhere, they get an 8 this time.
Doesn't look like it.
Yep. Yep. That's okay. Just makes it a little more difficult. But, you know, if they're going to do it by means of the pass, that extra 5 yards can be a plus to the offense as opposed
to
a minus. You bet. Same formation they scored the touchdown on, Brian. Two wide outs, two tight end. Oh, a little stop pattern. Oh, nice defense that time.
Oh, Ruthie got hit hard.
Woo,
just, he 65. Just tried to release that ball.
Yeah, Darryl Michael just nailed him. So, that's no good. But I tell you what, it's 17-6, Brian. There's a ball game again.
How much time we got left?
Oh, I just said that. 10 minutes, 26 seconds.
Anything can happen.
Well, I'll tell you what. Why don't we take a break? You're watching QCA TV, Channel 38. Yes, you are. Right now, Cost Communication is a Family Ties Productions. We'll be right back.
It'll be Pat Voss.
Now, you going to kick it deep, Brian, or are you going to try an onside kick here? What do you think? Too early for that? Moline thinks they're going to kick it short. That's
yeah, I
for
think
sure.
They do. I think I'd kick it.
Tell you what, there's a lot of openings back here. If he can pop this thing in the middle, it's going to be tough to pick up. Best is back there again. That ball is not going to roll out of bounds. Best picks it up to 13, back to 20, straight up the middle, and got it out to about the 29, 30-yard line. Not real fancy run that time. I'm going to run as far as I can, as fast as I can.
Nice tackle by number 88, Tony DeJulio, on that tackle. Ooh, did a nice,
nice
job there.
Very nice. Very nice.
We've heard that name before, haven't
yeah,
we?
Yeah, that's a fairly familiar name over there at Allman. All good athletes. Well, now Moline's got to go back to work again. Coming out of that huddle, Kyle Piper. He's 6'2". He's 227 pounds. Number 55, a senior. Back to the one-back set. Both teams are on a lot of one-back stuff now. Fullback up the middle. Beard on that carry. Well, that was a nice little gainer there.
Adam Stimson on the tackle.
See where they mark it. That's about a four-yard gain, Brian. And that line surge
didn't look
really
like
something.
It, did it?
No. Ball is on the 34-yard line. Second and six. Susan, that offensive line there. Ball's on the ground again. That snap just got loose from the start. Mike Finch didn't have that one to begin with. We're 56 is in there now. Grant McCauley's playing at one of the either guard or tackle spots. 77.
And Moline has made a lot of mistakes in this ball.
Chris Burns.
Game.
Chris Burns, you want to watch a kid come off the football. Big kid. Chris Burns is not in right now. 77 coming off the site. Just came out of the ball game. Chris is 6'4", 310-pounder. He's a junior. But he's in that offensive line right now, too. Number 84 runs the play in the ball game. That's Phil Ledbetter. And they use Ledbetter, Sable, Cave, and Blythe, all as people to run plays in the ball game. Arms. Split wide out to this side. Speed option. Nowhere to run. Allman made a stop. Allman holds.
Big hit by Adam Stimson that time as he got in that backfield and traced that quarterback down and put him on the ground.
Really did. They got Finch headed backwards that time too. So a good decision. He could have pitched it, but when you're going backwards like that, the pitch is going to lose you more yards and maybe a fumble. But he took about a one-yard loss. That's up fourth down and about eight. And the ball is at about the 31-yard line. Motion. They got to call a penalty on that. The end on this side moved a little bit early.
So Moline held the three and out that time.
That's right. Well, they had a nice punt return to kind of get themselves back in good field position, but in three downs, they were only able to gain about 2 yards. Now they're going to lose five on a penalty. So really, in three downs, we're now at a negative three for Moline. So momentum,
you know, even though Moline won the battle on the trenches, they've made a lot of little mistakes here. Four turnovers?
Three or four turnovers? Four or five fumbles. Beautiful kick this
time.
Did
he hang that
ball? Oh, my. That ball off the face mask. Moline recovers. What a great punt. That was set up by a beautiful punt by Adam Kettler, the 200-pound senior fullback linebacker. Did a beautiful
job.
Did
he hang that up there?
That ball spent forever in the air, and the turnover goes Moline's way, Brian.
But you had to feel for Bill on that, as he waited for that ball for so long, and the people were all standing around him, you know. Pretty soon you start to think, you know.
Well, you do. And again, a ball, I'll tell you, a kick like that could get up higher than the lights pretty soon. It's coming down, you know, and you don't get a good look at that thing. My, oh my, what a great punt. Now Moline in great field position with an opportunity. They're one drive away. They're going toe-to-toe in there, Brian. They're just going to knock each other down now. Quarterback keep. Off tackle, got him by the shirt, though.
You don't run around Chris Edwards.
No, you sure don't. Grip of steel. He had him by the shirt, and he wanted to let go.
That time, you and I could have walked behind that center and walked for 20 yards before we'd have been touched.
Yep, boy.
The center and two guards took about 5 yards right there, all in one step, I think.
Well, when Moline jumps down in there with that toe-to-toe formation and the wishbone, they're just going to wedge block that thing. They're going to come off there, and they're going to put shoulder pad to shoulder pad. And when you put, well, most of the game you've had Kyle Piper at center and Daryl Michael at one guard. I'll try to get you the other guard over there, 54. That is...
Yeah, we got got something wrong there, a legal motion or illegal procedure. Yep. Something illegal, Jim.
It's not right. It's just not right.
Yes.
It's just not right. Illegal shift.
At least we haven't seen that call aiding the runner this week.
We had it called early last week, though,
yes,
didn't we?
Yes, we did.
Yes, we did. I've had a couple comments on that, too.
Have you?
Yes, I have. They think, now listen to this. Can you believe this one? They think we don't even go to the game. And, like, then we come back and, like, sit in our studio.
Is that right?
Our plush studio there high above the LeClaire Hotel. And then we do these games, like, after we watch them on TV.
I'll tell you what, if we didn't go to the game, we wouldn't be there at all.
Yeah.
We enjoy these games.
You better believe it. We're here, and whatever mistakes we're making them live.
Oh, my. Healy.
Oh, my gracious. Good run into that football.
Oh, my great time. Defense that time.
Woo.
They had them all covered.
That was a great pursuit angle that time. Player slow getting up for Allman. I can't see who it is, Brian, but he's a little slow getting up. Number 60.
Oh, that's Adam Stimson. He's had some big hits tonight.
He is. Adam's a junior.
He's back.
He brings a load, though. He's 5'10", 200-pounder, so he's going to flack around that field and hit people. No, I tell you, we're at the old ballpark. Tonight, I tell you, we are in the... What would you call where we're at tonight? These are like the sky boxes.
Catbird seat.
We are in the catbird seat. This is like the sky boxes here. They've been coming around with food and pizza and...
The hors d'oeuvres have been fantastic.
Coach, we get steak after...
Yeah, we got that coming up.
Steak coming up after we're done here.
The view here, I don't know if the cameraman caught it, but the view of the
houses
across the street, I mean, we're right up here where you can see it all.
Well, now this is setting the precedent because we're here at Moline. Now, next week, we're going to be at UT. Now, we've had pizza. I think the popcorn guy's been by twice. We've had plenty of pop, M&M's with peanuts.
It gets better every week,
though. I confess that one, M&M with peanuts, and the steak dinner's coming as soon as the game's over with.
So we got a lot to look forward next week, don't you think?
If you know any board members over at UT, you better get them on this one.
I don't know anybody over there. But we know Doug Howell was on there.
Well, Doug Howell.
He could help.
Doug Howell will help us.
Yeah.
Okay.
Here we go.
Third and 13 for the Maroons. Shift to the double wing.
Uh-oh.
And Moline jumps early. Grant McCauley was off that ball in a hurry, though. He did do that. And I used to tell the kids, if you're going to screw up like that, come off in a hurry.
Yeah. Don't take a
don't
step
just
and stop.
Stand up.
You're going to take a step, hit somebody.
No, get off that ball and hit somebody. But unfortunately, the coach isn't going to buy that because he's coming out. 65 is back in the ball game. Daryl Michael.
I can read his lips. He says, if you're going to take a step, hit somebody.
That's right. Yeah.
No.
That's pretty good.
Here we go again.
Third and long. Counter. Inside counter. Look out! Vest on a nice run down around the 30-yard line. And it gives Moline an opportunity to get a first down.
Tackled by John Kearney.
Sets up
and Matt Franks.
Fourth and five, Brian.
Excuse me.
But it's all right. Ball's at the 30-yard line. 5 minutes, 52 seconds to go, Brian, here in the fourth quarter. Allman needs the ball back and need it back in a hurry. Kyle Piper brings him out. Coach, he looked pretty good, number 44, as a fullback, but he looks real good as a linebacker and center at number 55. Ball's on the ground again. Moline's going to recover, but it's going to be Allman's ball. That ball must be getting slippery or something, Brian.
I don't know. It's been pretty slippery for the Maroons the whole game.
It really has.
If this would have been, a little tighter ball game, those turnovers would have really cost them, I'm afraid.
No question about that. Well, here's another drive where there's every opportunity for them to make a fourth and five. If they get off the ball like they can, they're going to pick up 5 yards there. That keeps this drive alive. That could be points. Two other fumbles, could have easily set up touchdowns. And the one fumble on the punt down here gave Allman their touchdown.
Yeah.
So you're talking about a difference of maybe 4 scores in this ballgame.
Yeah.
Well, you got the ball again. Boy, look at the wideouts now. There are wideouts everywhere. Oh, nice job of dropping that defensive end off. Man coverage.
Healy wide
the
open.
Ball and took a big hit. 34 that time.
Pass was there.
Matt Siemens comes up and laid a hit on him.
Oh,
you're going to get hit that hard, you might as well go ahead and catch the ball, huh?
Ruthie really took a hit on that. He just threw that ball and got creamed.
You know, Moline, you got to give the defensive coaches for Moline a lot of credit because that was a formation that really we haven't seen Alleman use in the games that we've covered them. And yet, all of a sudden, they dropped the defensive end off. Number 81 dropped off. Aaron Blythe and played man coverage on a tight end. Did a nice job. Pressure on the quarterback again. That's a good
play. That's a nice throw. Healy gets the ball. Sheds one tackle.
Look who's out there. Number 55 is in the middle of that one again. Kyle Piper. Under that football, number 34, Matt Siemens was there again.
How big is Piper?
Piper, coach, is 6'2", 227 pounds.
He looks familiar to me.
Coach, he played well last year. If I'm not mistaken, he was the all-conference center a year ago, if I'm not mistaken. If I am mistaken, I apologize again. I've made mistakes before. Oh, big hit
nice
there.
Nice hole there as Barry gets through there a little bit. It closed in a hurry, but there was a good opening there for a second.
32, Nick Massa was on that tackle, along with a couple other players. And Alleman's got to go for this one now. Fourth down, 4 minutes, 31 seconds to go. Probably the last chance they're going to have to get back in this ball game. Fourth and three. Well, this is what you call a big play. This is a huge play.
This is the fourth and 3 yard play.
That's right. If you got one of those, you need to put this
it's
in right
now. It's
time
to use it right here.
All right, formation. Oh, it's not going to work. My gracious. Davis is in on that one, number 79. Unbelievable penetration by the defensive tackles.
Oh,
the whole
was,
side of the line got through that time.
They was maroon all throughout that backfield.
Now, I'll tell you what, if you're Moline now, I think you really, to set the tempo for next week, to get your confidence back up, I think they need to take this ball and drive it right in there right now. I think if they drop the ball on the field another time or two in this ball game, next week's ball game is going to be, a whole lot different. They need to build some confidence in the offense right now. First and 10.
We'll
see. Alleman's,
Alleman's not
going to
quit.
No, not at all. No place to go.
Oh, Ryan Wood just plugged everything up there.
Lofgren on the carry that time.
Justin Hubbs come up in there also. They just plugged that whole side up.
Well, if you want to see aggressive defense right now, take a look at the white shirts. They had everybody up on the ball that time. If Moline has an opportunity to run and had time to throw a play-action pass, it's got to be 6 points right now, if you can block it. That's the big thing. That's the problem when you call these, is do you have enough guys to block that thing?
Ooh.
Handback this time, little handback, short gain.
Did that line even get set that time?
I'm not sure. But
looked like they come out of the huddle and just ran right on by the ball.
Exactly. Timeout, Alleman. That'll be their second timeout. We got 3 minutes, 22 seconds to go, Brian. Let's take a short break, and we'll be right back with the final of this ball game. So remember that the Independent Insurance Services Incorporated have joined us as a major sponsor. We promised you, Brian and I have promised you more information by next week's ball game. They're located in Davenport, 1519 East Locust Street. So if you're in line for some kind of independent insurance services, these are the people to get a hold of. We'll be right back.
Third and 9.
Oh, nice
right
dive.
Up the middle.
Off tackle.
He's going to get about 7 yards out of it.
He sure did. Chris Beard that time over the guard. And another quick timeout. That'll be Alleman's last timeout. So 3:13 to go. 3:13.
Well, I guarantee you this time there'll be 11 men on the line of scrimmage with Pioneers.
Well, and I'll tell you what, it'd be a first down here by Moline. I'll just kind of just wrap this whole thing up. But if Alleman makes a stop, they're one big play away from being, in the thick of this thing. And that's the way they got to be thinking using this timeout right now. Still stayed a perfect night. A little nervous about the rain. I wasn't 100% sure we were going to be inside over here. But when Jess called me way in advance tonight, called me about 10 after 5. Said we're on a go. He said we had spots in there. We want to thank, really do. I'm being serious now. Thank the administration and the staff here at Moline High School for providing us with this facility.
It's been fantastic.
What did you call it earlier? The catbird seat? Is this what this is? We got it. And if it had rained.
Never been treated so nicely.
It's very nice. We appreciate it. We appreciate it.
And I'll tell you what, Moline's looking like they're going to have a very fine year.
Yes, they are. Yes, they are. Well, they're looking to go 3-0. First down here will seal that for them. Off tackle, Beard, he might have got that first down. He looks like he dove across that.
I believe he did.
First down marker does
first
pick up
ten,
the
Moline.
First down. Alleman's out of timeouts now, so it's just a matter of running out the last 3 minutes and 9 seconds. They'll start the clock as soon as they have the chain set. The referee signals starting the clock, and we're on it now. Moline's going to run a few more plays here, and we'll just see how this ball game ends. But I agree with you. Moline's impressive. I've seen him twice now out of the three games that they've played. Been impressed both times.
Well, we haven't got a chance to actually see Rocky. We know that they're good.
Right. Beard off tackle. Look at the blocking downfield that time. Number 78's down in there real hard trying to throw a block. It's Ben McKay. He's a senior. Ben's a senior. Again, Moline has run a lot of people in and out of this ball game. A lot of backs again. They've used some, a variety of backs. They all run up in there real hard. I commented on that a year ago. They did that too. But this year, in the games that we've seen, Coach McGuire's doing a beautiful job. Why don't we go through the coaching staffs on both these teams if we can, Coach? We've got for Moline, Dan McGuire's the head coach. We've got, we got Wayne Cables in there, Steve Ford, Bill Burris, Dan Byrne, Paul Carter, Kevin Gorgel, John Kilgore, Jeff O'Hearn, Joel Reiser, Kelly Wynn. We got some volunteers, Corey Christensen, Frank Hernandez, Rich Palmer, and Crick Santamore. Coach, that's about one coach for each player.
Well, yeah.
No wonder they did so well, huh? Yeah. How about for all of them?
For all of them, of course, the head coach is Dana Just, and the assistant coaches Dave DeJager, Todd DePorter, and Matt O'Brien.
Well, sophomore staff, you got Jay Hatch, huh? Mike Ebner, Steve Kale, Kurt Johansson, Phil Saylor. Good staffs.
You bet.
Well, it's obvious when you watch the teams take the field. It's obvious they're getting a lot of good coaching.
Quarterback keeps it. Turn it up.
Gonna be short. It's gonna be a fourth down situation. We're down to a minute 27. Moline again this week is using a little bit of what we call an end-over formation, where they're actually unbalanced that time to the left. All you have is a guard or a tackle on our side of the field that time, and an end gives you an extra blocker. Also, you've got a wide receiver to that side. So gives you a little more power running towards that strong side of the formation. So we'll see if they go back to that again or they come out with a balanced line. This time they're balanced. Tight splits, fourth and a yard. Beard, boy, look at that line
surge. Yes.
We'll stop the clock here. First down for Moline with 49.9 seconds, Bryant.
Piper got up about 11, 12 yards down the field there off his block.
Well, I'll tell you, I've been impressed with him. The last center I've watched quite a bit of football, but I'll tell you, Pat went at UT a few years ago, and there was a kid who played guard at UT that ended up playing center in college. I think his name was Mama. We saw a lot of guys disappear when he was blocking him. But as far as center play is concerned, this is as good as I've seen in a long time.
He's a good athlete.
Yes,
he should have a good future.
Mike Finch takes a knee, and we're down to 18 seconds. Brian, that's going to be the last play of the ball game.
Well, we've seen a lot of football the last few weeks. Moline looks like a tough team to beat.
Well, I think I agree with you. I think and they've got some work to do. They put that ball on the field way too many times. I'm sure if we read about in the paper tomorrow, Coach McGuire and his coaches are going to be talking a lot about missed opportunities. If we hadn't laid the ball on the ground, this ball game could have been something like 30-something to nothing. And very easily been a 30-something to nothing ball game. But I think we need to give credit to Alleman. They hung in there. They hit hard. They were aggressive. But Moline tonight was a much better football team.
Yep. So next week, where are we heading?
We're going back over to the Panther, home of the Panthers. Mike Tracy's UT Panthers got them on a roll. I'm going to predict they're 4-0.
And the Maroons again, huh?
And the Maroons coming back. This could be one of those big three matchup games that I talked about a little bit earlier, Moline and UT in a matchup of the unbeaten. So, again, we want to, again, welcome aboard our sponsor, the Independent Insurance Services Incorporated, 1519 East Locust Street in Davenport, Iowa. Welcome aboard, and we appreciate their help bringing us to the ball games. Brian, I've had fun tonight. How about you?
Oh, it's been a ball.
Yep.
Every week is this way. I mean, I'm looking forward to next week also, just to get a chance to see these teams meet as the thing just builds and builds each week, you know. And you know, if you're East Moline, they've been here looking tonight. They're going to think how they can attack this, you know. So
I don't know where the raffle tickets are at.
We're out of here.
We got a guy for a raffle ticket.
Let's check out of here and get a raffle ticket.
Head out of here. For Brian Mumma, this is Jim Sanders. We'll see you next time.
Indian headquarters Eagle did sell out. We have